हाय लिसनर्स, नमस्कार। रेडियो द्वारका में फिर आपका बहुत बहुत स्वागत है एंड वेलकम बैक टू अनदर मोटिवेटिंग एपिसोड ऑफ इको वाइज मुलाकात। इट इज इंडीड एन एनरिचिंग एक्सपीरियंस टू मीट स्टॉलवर्ड्स ऑफ डाइवर्स फील्ड्स। टुडे वी हैव विद अस डॉक्टर शाजी प्रभाकरन, रीजनल डेवलपमेंट ऑफिसर फॉर साउथ एंड सेंट्रल एशिया एट फीफा। Dr. Shaji Prabhakaran has a rich experience in football and sports management. He has planned and executed numerous international projects in multiple countries across the globe with success. Dr. Prabhakaran ne Lakshmibai Institute of Physical Education se PhD ki hai. He also has an MBA in marketing and sports business management and diploma in sports management. His topic of research was why Indian football is not doing well. From there, he went to coach and later run the Chandigarh Football Academy. He has held various positions in AIFF and AFC, implemented grassroots and youth development programs in India, started his own football consultancy and is currently working with FIFA. Aiye, milte hai Dr. Prabhakaran se. Welcome Dr. Prabhakaran to the show.
Thank you. It's my pleasure.
Let's begin with your childhood days. आपका बचपन कहाँ गुजरा? अपने फैमिली बैकग्राउंड के बारे में बताइए।
मेरा बचपन गुजरा है एक बड़े रिमोट प्लेस में, बंगाल के, वो डुआर्स एरिया उसको कहते हैं, और ये बिल्कुल नॉर्थ ईस्ट पार्ट में है, नॉर्थ बंगाल पे है, और इस जगह का नाम है बिन्नागुड़ी, और मैं वहीं पे बड़ा हुआ हूँ। बल्कि मेरा जन्म केरल में हुआ है, और क्योंकि मेरे पेरेंट्स वहाँ शिफ्ट हो गए थे, वो उनका बिजनेस था रेलवे के साथ कैटरिंग का, तो मैं एक ऐसे जगह पला बड़ा हूँ जहाँ पे 80% बच्चे जो है स्कूल जाते नहीं थे, क्योंकि उनकी इकोनॉमिक कंडीशन और उनका जो बैकग्राउंड था वो उसको मतलब स्कूल जाने लायक नहीं थे, क्योंकि वो बहुत गरीब बच्चे थे। तो उस जगह पे पला बड़ा हूँ, और बहुत छोटे से ही फुटबॉल से कनेक्शन हो गया था, क्योंकि हमारे एरिया में फुटबॉल बहुत ही लोकप्रिय था, और जो मेन फुटबॉल फील्ड था वो जस्ट 1 किलोमीटर अवे था घर से। और मैं केंद्रीय विद्यालय में पढ़ा हूँ क्लास 1 से क्लास 12 तक, और स्कूल में भी हमें स्पोर्ट्स बहुत एंकरेजमेंट मिलता था। बल्कि स्कूल में फुटबॉल उतना पॉपुलर स्पोर्ट नहीं था, वहाँ पे क्रिकेट, वॉलीबॉल, बास्केटबॉल, ये सारे स्पोर्ट्स खेले जाते थे। लेकिन हम घर पे, हमारे कम्युनिटी में जहाँ हम रहते थे, वहाँ पे फुटबॉल सबसे ज्यादा लोकप्रिय था। लेकिन तभी भी एक ये सीजनल स्पोर्ट्स था, अप्रैल से सितंबर तक ही खेलते थे, उसके बाद सीजन खत्म हो जाता था। और हमारा जो एरिया था ये पूरे टी गार्डनों से भरा पड़ा था, तो मैं टी गार्डन की टीम के साथ खेलता था। और जब मैं 8-9 साल का था तभी से फुटबॉल खेलने लगा था, लेकिन सीरियस हो गया था 12-13 साल से, और फिर 16 साल में ही मैं मेन टीम में आ गया था टी गार्डन्स के। तो लेकिन वहां हमें कोई कोचिंग या कोच के नाम पे ऐसा कुछ था नहीं, क्योंकि वैसी कोई ऑर्गेनाइजेशन नहीं थी, बस सब खेलते थे और जो बड़े लोग गाइड करते थे उस तरह से हम खेलते चले गए। और जो आज मैं हूँ, जो भी आज जिंदगी में हासिल किया है मैंने, वो बस मैं फुटबॉल के वजह से किया है। अगर फुटबॉल मेरा पार्ट ऑफ लाइफ नहीं होता तो शायद मैं ऐसा कुछ हासिल नहीं कर पाता, आज मैं द्वारका में भी नहीं होता, आज मैं दिल्ली में भी नहीं होता, और मैं आज मैं फीफा के साथ भी नहीं होता। तो इसलिए मेरी बहुत सारी यादें जुड़ी हैं बचपन से।
तो आप कभी ये ड्रीम करते थे कि आप फुटबॉलर बनेंगे, या आपने कभी सोचा था कि आप फुटबॉल से इतने क्लोजली एसोसिएटेड रहेंगे प्रोफेशनली?
ऐसा सोचा तो नहीं था कि मैं क्या करूंगा, क्या बनूंगा, लेकिन मुझे ये जरूर थी कि मतलब मैं कुछ करूं फुटबॉल में, और क्योंकि छोटे से ही मैंने फुटबॉल पे बहुत टाइम लगाया है, और मैं बहुत फॉर्चुनेट समझता हूं कि आज मैं फुटबॉल से बिल्कुल जुड़ा हुआ हूं, और पिछले 20 साल में मैंने फुटबॉल में बहुत कुछ किया है। और अगर मैं देखता हूं जब बचपन या मेरे कॉलेज डेज, तो मुझे नहीं लगता था कि ऐसा कुछ होगा, क्योंकि कोई क्लियर पाथवे नहीं था, और मैं किसी को देखा नहीं कि मैं कोई फुल टाइम फुटबॉल में जॉब कर रहा है या फुटबॉल के लिए कुछ काम कर रहा है, क्योंकि जो भी देखता था खिलाड़ियों को ही देखता था, और जो करता धरता थे वो बिल्कुल नजर में भी नहीं आते थे और पता भी नहीं चलता था उनके बारे में।
Then how did you end up doing a course in Lakshmibai National Institute of Physical Education, Gwalior?
Because there were two, three things which played a role for me to get there. One was definitely, wanted to become a better player, and then wanted to continue my career in sports. And then from my school, few seniors, those were better sportsmen, they got into this college, and they guided me, you can also join the college because you can get a better training and also think of a career in sports. So that's how, I was linked to this college.
आपने फिर ग्रेजुएशन के बाद क्या किया, कहाँ ज्वाइन किया?
मैंने ग्रेजुएशन किया, उसके बाद अपना पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन किया उसी कॉलेज से, इंस्टीट्यूट से. फिर पोस्ट ग्रेजुएशन के बाद मैंने पीएचडी की, क्योंकि मुझे यूजीसी का फेलोशिप मिला था. नेट और जीआरएफ क्वालिफाई कर ली थी मैंने, तो फिर मुझे, और मुझे तभी भी मुझे पता नहीं था कि मैं क्या करूं, तो इसलिए मैं अपने पढ़ाई को प्रोलोंग करना चाहता था, क्योंकि मैं ये नहीं चाहता था कि मैं ग्रेजुएशन के बाद जस्ट कुछ जॉब कर लूं, क्योंकि मुझे इस ये मतलब मेरा टारगेट था कि मैं कुछ अलग करूं स्पोर्ट्स में. और क्योंकि मुझे इंजरी हो गई थी उस कॉलेज के टाइम ही, बहुत सीरियस इंजरी हो गई थी, तो मुझे मतलब अपना जो फुटबॉल का कैरियर था उसको समाप्त करना पड़ा, क्योंकि इंजरी इतनी सीरियस थी कि उसका ट्रीटमेंट भी अफोर्डेबल नहीं था मेरे लिए एट दैट टाइम. तो फिर मैं एकेडमिक्स में ज्यादा फोकस कर रहा था, और तो मैं वहां रहते हुए अपने आप को ये सोच रहा था कि मैं क्या करूं, कुछ नया करना चाहता था, तो इसलिए मैंने वहां से पीएचडी भी कर डाली, क्योंकि फेलोशिप मिल गया था, तो इस वजह से फाइनेंशियली प्रॉब्लम नहीं थी.
फिर उसके बाद आपने क्या किया?
तो जैसे ही मैंने पीएचडी खत्म की, उसके बाद फिर मैं जॉब देख रहा था कि मैं क्या करूं फुटबॉल में. तो ये बहुत आसान नहीं था, क्योंकि मुझे पीएचडी करने के बाद बहुत सारे काम करने के अपॉर्चुनिटीज थे कॉलेज में, यूनिवर्सिटीज में और दूसरे संस्थाओं में, लेकिन मेरा इंटरेस्ट था कि मैं फुटबॉल में कुछ करूं. तो फिर मैं दिल्ली आके अपने फ्रेंड के घर रहता था और सोचता था कि मैं क्या करूं, लेकिन फिर ऐसा टाइम आया कि फाइनेंशियली मैं कॉप अप नहीं कर पा रहा था, तो फिर मैंने कॉलेज ज्वाइन कर ली ऐसे, फॉर टाइम टू अर्न समथिंग, दैट टू इन नगलोय दैट कॉलेज. बट देन आई रेड समथिंग इन न्यूज़पेपर इन टाइम्स ऑफ इंडिया दैट चंडीगढ़ इज प्लानिंग टू स्टार्ट एन अकेडमी फॉर फुटबॉल. तो देन आई गॉट इन टच विद पीपल हुम आई न्यू इन चंडीगढ़, and then I approached them, then I extended my service to them, and I was fortunate that they accepted my application. But I have really served for them first 3 months free, because they took the process more than 4 months to complete my recruitment. But then it was a kind of a part-time job, because it was not for money, because they used to pay very, very minimal, maybe you can say 100 rupees per day to work in an academy. That was the kind of a salary I was getting. But then I was very focused, I was, because something I wanted to do, and that given me a platform. And there I coached 24 kids the first year, and we were fortunate that within 3 years, we could produce 6 international players from the academy. They represented for India under 14, under 13 team. And this very rare, instance where you can see from one academy, this many players playing for the country. But at the same time, I also used to teach in different colleges in Chandigarh and also in university as a guest faculty, because that's how I used to earn my living. But, football was the true passion for me, and I'm really fortunate that I got that break in Chandigarh, and that's how I can say the journey started for me in, as a professional guy in football.
After Chandigarh Football Academy, you got opportunity to work with All India Football Federation. What was your role then? Tell us about this phase of your career.
Yeah, at that time, 2004, I took players for trials from my academy, and then 6 of them got selected. The trials were in Goa, and then I had the opportunity to meet the AFF bosses, and then I said, I'm keen to work with the federation, and they were very positive, and then they took me as their in charge for the grassroots and youth development to begin with, but then I ended up handling the national teams, handling women's football, handling coach education, everything since the beginning. And then 2005 we shifted to Delhi, where AIFF for the first time it constructed an headquarter through FIFA support. And we moved with 4 staff in Delhi, and then that's how the All India Football Federation grown from, 4 or 5 full-time staff. Now they have 60 plus staff. And then I worked here as the director for the development, director for the national teams, and was managing different competitions, different development programs. It was really a fascinating experience, working with All India Football Federation, because it given me a lot of opportunity to learn about the game and to how to manage the game. And then I put my, experience into practice, and that's how I started also staying in Dwarka since 2005. I've seen, how Dwarka also grown in last 10 years. It's really, because of football, traveled, across India, and it's really, feel good that, I'm staying in Dwarka and I've seen this place grow.
Currently you're working with FIFA as a regional development officer for South and Central Asia. How did your association with FIFA begin and what is your role here? FIFA ke kya kya projects hai uske baare mein bhi thoda sa bata dijiye.
हाँ, फीफा के साथ जुड़ना एक बहुत ही फॉर्चुनेट सिचुएशन था मेरे लिए, क्योंकि मैंने कभी सोचा नहीं था कि मैं फीफा के साथ भी काम करूंगा, लेकिन अपॉर्चुनिटी मिली 2011 में, जब उनका प्लान था कि इंडिया में वो एक डेवलपमेंट ऑफिस खोलने का प्लान कर रहे थे और वो देख रहे थे कि किसको अपॉइंट करे, और ये जो डेवलपमेंट ऑफिस था ये पहले कोलंबो में था, और वो इस ऑफिस के थ्रू वो साउथ एंड सेंट्रल एशिया के डिफरेंट प्रोजेक्ट्स, डिफरेंट प्रोग्राम्स जो फीफा चलाती है, डिफरेंट एक्टिविटीज, उसको मैनेज करते हैं. तो 2011 में मुझे ये सौभाग्य मिला कि मैं फीफा के साथ काम करूं, और ये बहुत ही, मतलब मैं अपने आप को लकी समझता हूं कि ये अपॉर्चुनिटी मुझे मिली, और इसके द्वारा हम इंडिया में बहुत सारे प्रोजेक्ट्स लागू कर पाए, इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर प्रोजेक्ट, डिफरेंट सॉफ्ट प्रोजेक्ट, डिफरेंट एकेडमी प्रोजेक्ट, और अभी इंडिया अगले साल अंडर 17 वर्ल्ड कप होस्ट भी करेगी, तो और पूरे साउथ एशिया में, पूरे सेंट्रल एशिया में हमने बहुत सारे प्रोजेक्ट्स किए, और इससे बहुत कुछ सीखने को मिला, और बहुत कुछ हमने कामयाबी भी हासिल की, और कंट्रीज लाइक अफगानिस्तान भी जा चुका हूँ बहुत बार, वहाँ भी बहुत सारे डेवलपमेंट प्रोजेक्ट्स हमारे हैं, और ये देख के अच्छा लगता है कि फुटबॉल से लोगों को कितनी संतुष्टि और एक पॉजिटिव एंगेजमेंट का एक दरिया है. तो इससे, मतलब मैं ये नहीं कहूंगा कि मेरा कंट्रीब्यूशन है, ये फीफा का कंट्रीब्यूशन है, और हम सिर्फ इस चीज को इम्प्लीमेंट करते हैं और प्लानिंग करते हैं, लेकिन फीफा ये चाहती है कि, मतलब, फुटबॉल ज्यादा से ज्यादा लोगों के पास पहुंचे और लोगों को अच्छी सुविधा मिले खेलने के लिए, और ये जो गेम है ये इंडिया में और ज्यादा प्रगति करे, और इसलिए बहुत सारे प्रोजेक्ट्स, प्रोग्राम्स यहाँ पे लागू किए गए हैं, जो और ऑल इंडिया फुटबॉल फेडरेशन अभी तक बहुत पॉजिटिवली और बहुत कंस्ट्रक्टिवली फुटबॉल डेवलपमेंट पे काम कर रहे हैं, और हम पूरा सहयोग कर रहे हैं उनको उनकी सारी जरूरतों को पूरा करने की कोशिश करते हैं विद इन आवर फ्रेमवर्क, विद इन द एग्जिस्टिंग पॉलिसीज एंड प्रोजेक्ट्स.
कंपेयर टू क्रिकेट, फुटबॉल इज जस्ट गेटिंग पॉपुलर. आपको लगता है कि ये पॉपुलैरिटी कंटिन्यू होगी और इट विल अट्रैक्ट मोर क्राउड?
या नो डाउट, फुटबॉल इज गेटिंग वेरी पॉपुलर अमंग द यूथ एंड स्पेशली अर्बन सिटीज एंड टाउन्स, एंड इट इज जस्ट फ्यू इयर्स अवे वेयर फुटबॉल काइंड ऑफ डोमिनेट इंडिया. दो डेफिनेटली इंडिया टीम इज नॉट डूइंग ग्रेट, बट देन द काइंड ऑफ डेवलपमेंट इनिशिएटिव्स अंडरटेकन बाय AIFF एंड इट्स एफिलिएटेड यूनिट्स विल डेफिनेटली ब्रिंग फ्रूट्स इन 5 to 10 इयर्स टाइम. बट फुटबॉल इज काइंड ऑफ अ नंबर वन स्पोर्ट फॉर द यूथ, And whenever I interact with the youth or we go to schools, colleges, there everyone wants to play football. And that's really, really, you know, very encouraging. And our research shows that it is just 4 percentile below than cricket. And though cricket is very popular, India has achieved great, great results. But football is not far behind. And I'm sure, you know, football will bring also laurels to the country. And FIFA is very keen, you know, to support India in terms of developing its football. And thus, you know, under 17 FIFA World Cup will be taking place. And I don't think that would be the last competition FIFA will host in India. There may be more competitions coming in future.
Yeah, there was a time in 1950s when football was at its peak in India. Like in 1951, Asian Games, India won gold medal, and in 56 Olympics, it was at fourth position. Duran Cup is also one of the world's oldest cup tournaments of India. Then, in spite of this, India is much behind other countries. Why India's position has declined over the years?
See, in 50s, in 60s, we kind of dominated Asia. That's no doubt. Yeah. And, but the problem is that, you know, from 80s, many countries have started their development initiatives. And India was not that resourceful in 60s, 70s and 80s. And India could not initiate development programs. And that's how we have, you know, we have gone back. And the other countries have gone forward because of their development initiatives. And it's only last 4 years, you know, India has started development initiatives in football. So therefore, I see, you know, it takes 10 to 15 years to bring about a change in any sporting environment. And that's will definitely happen, you know, in Indian football as well.
It is said that Indian diet and build is not suitable to match European players. Do you agree with this? What are other challenges for football players?
No, absolutely not. You know, diet and physical condition, I don't think, you know, it's an excuse given by some people, which I don't agree. Maybe in, you know, 60s, 70s, you know, our considerable populations were very poor. But now we have enough population, you know, and the latest obesity data shows that, you know, 12% women are obese, overweight, 9.3% men are, you know, obese and overweight. That shows, you know, we don't lack nutrition. We are overeating. Yeah. So that's not a problem. We have enough population in the country, you know, which are having, you know, good diet, balanced diet, and they are having, you know, good physical structure, structure and body type to compete among the best in the world. But the thing is that football means, you know, it has to start early. Yeah, and from the very early age, 4 or 5 years, one need to get exposed to football, and that's where the grassroots development initiatives, which is happening in India at present, will bear fruit in the times to come, because that was not the case 10 years back or 20 years back, where, you know, 4 or 5 years old, you know, playing football in an organized way, in a structured way, under a qualified coach. So things are changing. These are just excuses which doesn't hold true today. We can definitely compete among the best, but you know, we need to be patient, and we need to really work hard. We need to create opportunities for children. We need to engage them constructively, and we need to, and the government has a great role to play, because government cannot, you know, be sitting behind and, you know, only thinking of, you know, expecting big result unless they become proactive. They need to see, you know, children play. Children should be provided infrastructure facilities in schools, outside the school, in the community as well. And that's where we lack, you know, we don't have, you know, many playing fields, and even in the park, you know, many elders doesn't allow children to play. Because if the elders, they don't allow children to play or the youth to play, so they are, you know, not trying to channelize their energy constructively. So therefore, my appeal to all the elders, you know, those elderly people who spend their most of their time in the park in the evening, you know, they must encourage the children to play. They don't chase them out. They should not call the police, you know. They should think that, you know, if they, these children play game, any game, you know, they will be more constructive, they will be more productive, and they will be more supportive towards them, and they will understand the feelings of the elders in the society. But then, you know, we need to have a, you know, a concrete plan for that, you know, how we better utilize our park free spaces, and the government must think positively, because that's how we can engage the youth in a more constructive manner, and everyone will see the value of sport from that.
Bilkul theek kaha aapne. Children should be encouraged to play in the parks. Jyadatar TV ke samne hi baithe rehte hain bacche bhi. What changes are necessary to improve the level of Indian football, both at domestic and international level?
No, the changes are already happening. What we need to do is we need to, you know, take football to every nook and corner of the country. And definitely schools have a greater role, government has a greater role. The schools need to make football or sports an integral part of their education system. Though they say that, you know, sports are an integral part, but it is not the truth. Sports is the last priority. Every child who goes to school, he or she must have the opportunity to play some sport, because that's how we create a healthy society. And it is, you know, playing sport is not about, you know, only creating champion, but it's about many aspects, you know. So children who play sport, you know, they have better life skills. You know, what we need to do is, you know, football should exist everywhere, and different organizations involved with football, the clubs, the state associations, those NGOs, you know, should make, you know, use of football in terms of various development initiatives, not only to produce players, but to give society a better platform to work together and constructively progress. So what I would say is that country is big, so therefore we need to engage as many children into football as possible. Different clubs need to have their professional setup. Now the clubs are coming up with their professional setup where they will start their academies, where their talented children can go and train and can receive best of support and exposure. And we need to have a long-term plan, there is no doubt. The long-term plan with a vision and a long-term goal to see that, you know, India reaches to World Cup in maybe 2 decades time. And this is all possible because Indian in Olympics, our women's have done well, you know, and consistently our sports persons are, you know, doing well in different international competitions. So therefore, I don't see, you know, football cannot reach at the top level, but we need to be patient, we need to support, we need to encourage, we need to support, you know, the initiatives, and we need to also work as one, because if we are not coming as one, you know, and we do our own initiatives in isolation, that won't help. But the good thing is the federation has a strategic plan which is working towards, you know, developing football to a new level, and we all need to support them, we all need to be part of it, and we all need to feel positive out of it. And I'm sure we can, you know, force government to come up with certain plans, certain better funding for the game, for the sport. And we also need to see how our education policy can change, by which we can create a sports culture in India, which is very, very fundamental for to change the way we look towards sports.
The Indian Super League has become a big event with numerous number of international stars joining. How do you see ISL changing the popularity of football in India?
No, ISL no doubt has created a lot of hype about football, and it has shown to the world that, you know, India is really big about football, it loves football, and that's what it has done. It has given opportunity for children, for families to be in the stadium and to enjoy and experience football in a different way. So therefore, definitely it has made an impact, and I'm sure, you know, the league India will definitely have this kind of a league, which will be a bit long term, which where becomes a 365 days affair in terms of going forward, whereby the league can engage the fans in a positive manner for 24/7, 365 days, and that's how more children will get engaged into football and they will have more opportunity to play as well.
The Under 17 FIFA World Cup is going to be hosted in India. Iske baare mein kuch bataiye, kya kya preparations chal rahi hai?
Haan, ye jo Under 17 World Cup hai India mein, pehli baar ye vishw star ka football competition India mein organize kiya jayega. Aur ye agle October mein hoga, 2017 mein. Aur 6 cities mein ye competitions khele jayenge, Delhi mein, गोवा में, कलकत्ता में, गुवाहाटी में, कोची में और मुंबई में, और 6 स्टेडियम्स की तैयारियां चल रही हैं, और फीफा जो स्टेडियम्स के जो रिनोवेशन है, ट्रेनिंग 24 ट्रेनिंग पिचेस बन रहे हैं, उनको बिल्कुल क्लोजली मॉनिटर कर रहे हैं, और इसमें गवर्नमेंट भी बहुत ज्यादा प्रोएक्टिवली काम कर रही है, और हमारे प्राइम मिनिस्टर भी चाहते हैं कि ये जो फुटबॉल का कॉम्पिटिशन है, ये सबको कनेक्ट करे, यूथ को स्पेशली, और इस दिशा में गवर्नमेंट बहुत ही प्रोएक्टिवली सपोर्ट कर रही है फुटबॉल को. बहुत लोग ये कहते हैं कि ये गेम चेंजिंग इवेंट होगा फुटबॉल के लिए. डेफिनेटली जो वर्ल्ड के बेस्ट 24 टीमें यहाँ खेलेंगी, और ये इंडिया के लिए बहुत बड़ी उपलब्धि है कि जो फ्यूचर सितारे हैं फुटबॉल के, वो इंडिया में खेलेंगे, और बहुत सारे जो अभी जो वर्ल्ड के सितारे हैं वो अंडर 17 वर्ल्ड कप खेल चुके हैं, और ये बहुत ही ऊंचे लेवल का कंपटीशन है, और लोगों को इसके प्रति जुड़ना चाहिए, लोगों को इसको सपोर्ट करना चाहिए, और इससे दुनिया को एक मैसेज जाएगा कि इंडिया, ये ऐसा नहीं है कि खाली क्रिकेट के प्रति प्यार है, बाकी फुटबॉल के प्रति भी उतना ही प्यार है, और हम फुटबॉल को एक बिल्कुल ही नई दिशा दे सकते हैं इस वर्ल्ड कप के द्वारा.
Are there any plans to improve the state of football for girls or women's team? Focus is mainly on men's sport.
Yeah, worldwide jo women's football hai, ye bahut tezi se aage badh raha hai. Aur ye fastest growing sport hai among women's sports. Jo football, women football hai, wo fastest growing sport hai. Aur aap dekhenge ki जो अरबिक कंट्री में भी लड़कियां खेल रही हैं, और आपको ये सुनकर आश्चर्यचकित होंगे कि अभी जो वर्ल्ड कप अंडर 17 विमेंस फुटबॉल जॉर्डन में आयोजन हो रहा है, और ये पहली बार एक अरब कंट्री में विमेंस फुटबॉल कंपटीशन इस विश्व स्तर का हो रहा है, और वर्ल्ड वाइड मोर देन 30 मिलियन गर्ल्स फुटबॉल खेलते हैं, और रोज, और एशिया में विमेंस फुटबॉल बहुत ही पॉपुलर है, और जापान 2011 में विमेंस वर्ल्ड कप चैंपियन भी रह चुका है, और इंडिया में AIFF ये प्लान कर रही है कि विमेंस लीग स्टार्ट हो अगले साल, और फीफा इसको सपोर्ट कर रही है, और हम चाहते हैं कि ज्यादा से ज्यादा गर्ल्स खेलें, क्योंकि इसमें बहुत सारी सोशल इश्यूज हैं और विमेंस एम्पावरमेंट है, वो फुटबॉल के द्वारा हम इसको टैकल कर सकते हैं. तो जो बहुत सारे एनजीओज हैं इंडिया में, वो विमेंस फुटबॉल को प्रोत्साहित कर रहे हैं, तो ये एक अच्छी बात है, और हमें अपॉर्चुनिटीज बढ़ाने की जरूरत है, और हम ये चाहते हैं कि ज्यादा जो गेम को मैनेज करने के लिए भी महिलाएं आगे आए, और हमें जरूरत है कि महिला कोचेस भी बने ज्यादा, ताकि वो गर्ल्स फुटबॉल को खुद ही मैनेज करे, और ताकि गर्ल्स को ज्यादा प्रोत्साहन मिले फुटबॉल खेलने के लिए, और फैसिलिटीज का भी होना जरूरी है. तो लगता है कि मतलब विमेंस फुटबॉल जो है बहुत ही ज्यादा आगे जाके डेवलप करेगा इंडिया में, और क्योंकि इंडिया में अभी हरियाणा से जो एक सुब्रतो कप अभी अंडर 17 हुआ है, वो हरियाणा की गर्ल्स चैंपियन बनी है. तो जब हरियाणा जैसे स्टेट में विमेंस फुटबॉल खेलती हैं और विमेंस इतने कामयाब हैं, तो ये सब चीजें जो है एक मतलब इट गिव्स पॉजिटिव इंडिकेशन दैट द विमेंस फुटबॉल इज गोइंग स्ट्रांग, बट वी नीड टू एनकरेज मोर विमेंस टू प्ले फुटबॉल, and I am sure, you know, more women will come forward. I would like to see, you know, women entrepreneurs supporting football initiatives, because through CSR or through other social initiatives, because we have many women issues in India, and I think football can be one of the better mediums to empower women, give them better opportunities through football. So that way, you know, women's football can play a great role in the society itself and for the national building as well, and to create, you know, much respect for women as well, because we need to show that what women can do, you know, women are more capable in the society, and in sports they are not far behind. You know, we have all the success what we see in Olympics, you know, though the women's only bought it for India, and football can do much more for women. We need to encourage and we need to attract more participation of women into football.
Sports administration and FIFA activities must be taking lot of your time. However, what are your other hobbies, if any?
Writing a book, reading books.
You're writing a book on
yes,
what topic?
Yeah, I'm just finished that writing a book in football, which will be launched on 7th November. It's on football development on a global perspective. Last 1 year I was working on this project on my free time. It took considerable time because I was thinking, you know, it won't take that much time, but then, you know, it took all my free time and family time as well. But then it was an enjoyable experience, a learning experience, and I'm sure, you know, this book be liked by, you know, football enthusiasts all across the world, because it speaks about topics which were not covered by any author or any book previously. It talks about every aspect of football development, and it will, I'm sure, you know, it will create certain value, and I'm looking forward to get the reactions and the reviews and the feedback as soon as it is launched next month. And then, you know, I love, because of my job, you know, I'm very fortunate, I can travel a lot, and that keep me occupied. When you travel, you learn a lot, you know, to new countries, to you meet new people, you learn new culture. Although that's really, you know, though this was one of my hobby, traveling as well. But then this is very fortunate that because of football, I can travel a lot and I can learn a lot. I can meet a lot of people, and that's really giving me, you know, a lot of satisfaction in life. And that's what football definitely takes my considerable time, and it will always be like that because football is my number one passion.
Any message to aspiring footballers?
My message is keep working hard, you know, be passionate, don't get discouraged, don't get distracted, you know, keep your long, be focused, and listen to your coaches, listen to the elders, you know, and no failure should get you discouraged. Failure should be taken as a learning opportunity to improve, and keep a high goal, because don't be get satisfied easily, and the opportunities are plenty in football, and if you don't become even a player, you can have a wonderful career opportunity going forward. So therefore, my appeal to all of the parents and to the society is that, you know, encourage children to play, because they will be, you know, more constructive in their life, they will be more productive in their life, and they will, every parent will find being sport, their children will always do good in their life. So therefore, you know, always encourage children to play, and these children will always, you know, find a balance in terms of balancing their academic requirements. So therefore, it is about finding a balance being in sport doesn't mean, you know, they will be kind of neglecting their studies. It is not like that. You know, there are many instances where there are many examples where, you know, the top sportsmen are always the better in academics as well. But then how we create that situation at home, in school, you know, matters, because how we encourage children to be having a balanced life, and everything can go together. And it is based on the parental support and the society support and the school support, you know, we can really make best use of sport for the betterment of the child. And the other aspects, you know, becoming a champion or becoming top in the school, you know, that is all extra. Yeah, but we need to see is that how we develop a child as, you know, a very holistic way. And sports can play a great role developing better balance and a very constructive child.
Thank you, Dr. Prabhakaran, for sparing your time with Radio Dwarka. It was a pleasure talking to you.
Oh, it's all my pleasure. And really, for me, it was great talking to you. And I'm sure I'll keep coming again. Thank you.